Hello, welcome to Trading Floor. Today I'll be speaking to Mads Koefoed, who's the market strategist for Saxo Bank. Mads, we've had the fourth quarter earnings season kicking off this week. We've just two results so far. How have things gone on?
Well, obviously it's too early to judge, but after a couple of months of macro data that has been driving the markets, we are now tuning into another earnings season, and we expect this earnings season to be just like the previous one, that is a focus on beating expectations on earnings. If that is achieved as we expect, then we see the markets go higher, just as they did last quarter and the quarter before. So overall, we expect a higher stock market at the end of the earnings season, and we overall recommend investors to be long in stocks.
Are our earnings estimates still quite low?
They are indeed. It usually it seems like the research analysts lack the earnings that are actually achieved by companies. So once again, it appears as though they are overall quite low for the coming season that we have already entered this week, kicked off by Alcoa on Monday. So overall, yes, we believe they are too low, and thus companies in general will surprise to the upside.
Yeah. What can you tell us specifically about the two companies, Alcoa and Intel?
Well, Alcoa usually has a life of its own. They hit and miss at various quarters, but this quarter they missed. Came out at 1 cent versus 6 cents expected. After the market had thought about it a little, we just went straight back into the bullish mode that we've been for quite a while now. Looking at the report more specifically, it was quite poor. As I already mentioned, the earnings, we actually saw headline growth. And it's disturbing that earnings were not beaten when the headline was growing, because we've been talking so much about cost cutting for the last couple of quarters, and thus you would expect any increase in revenues to lead us on to more earnings per share, higher earnings per share. So disappointing.
Okay, and Intel?
Intel was quite good. They came out last night after the market had closed in the US and initially rallied quite a bit on the news, but then went back. We believe it's a very good report. They beat expectations and they beat earnings, and overall things are looking up. The price per unit sold increased. And while that signals that the volume didn't go up as much as perhaps you would have wanted, still it was a good report. The one drawback you could mention is that Windows 7 was launched last quarter, and perhaps you would have liked to see more reaction on that release. But overall, very good report, and if this keeps up, then surely we are. We are on the right road.
Okay. I mean, you look at things from a macro perspective, and we've got some earnings next week that should be interesting from that, which show sort of more global changes as well as sort of local changes.
Yes. First of all, we have a large number of banks coming out, and generally we believe banks will have nice earnings this quarter. It seems to have been a very good trading environment for banks that engages in such activities. And thus the trading part of revenues should be very good. So overall, we expect banks to do nicely also, because they have been cranking up rates on credit cards, and consumer spending has increased. So this should also increase revenues.
Yeah, speaking of credit cards, we've also got American Express next week.
Exactly. And we like to look at American Express to gauge how the credit environment in the US is. They usually inform, provide a lot of information on credit card usage and delinquencies and so on. And for that reason, it's interesting from a macro perspective.
Okay.
Lastly, we have two companies that provide a good picture of how the overall macroeconomic situation in the US is. And those are CSX and Burlington Northern Santa Fe, the company that Buffett has recently bought. Those are transportation companies, and thus provide a good feedback on how much how many goods are being transported around the country. Okay. So many interesting companies to come out next week.
Okay, and you've also released your macro forecast for January this week. Mm-hmm. I mean, can you tell us a little bit about how things look for the rest of the month?
Yes, it's a new publication that we have published twice, and as you said, the newest one is for January. And looking at the US, following this major upset in the payrolls that we saw last Friday, with a minus 85,000, I believe. We're looking for another negative number in the start of February, which is the January report. And we do so because overall, the labor market is weak. And in addition, the BLS, that is the Bureau of Labor Statistics, will provide a major revision to the series. And we expect, therefore, the non-farm payrolls series to get more in line with other employment indicators that have been weaker than the non-farm payrolls.
Okay. In terms of macro data, there's not a huge amount from the US next week, and the stock markets are closed on Monday for Martin mm-hmm. Luther King Day. What have we sort of got looking forward?
Well, we have a few macro numbers out. We have the producer price index and housing starts, but as you said, it's quite a boring week, if you could say so, in terms of macro data. And I believe anyway that the market will turn their attention to stocks. So the focus will be on the company's reporting earnings.
Okay, so all focus on equities for next week then.
Definitely.
Thanks a lot, Matt.
Welcome.